You can put that dress away, Rose.
Are we not attending the ball this evening?
Here we are. But I shall wear the white and silver instead. And my hair, will you do it just the way you like, with the circlet of jewels and flowers?
Of course. You look perfect.
Good. Rose.
Is everything all right?
I cannot sleep. It is quite late for you to be up too, is it not?
There's much to be done. If you're nervous about the wedding, you need not worry. I assure you, I'm managing everything. I will be ready.
I know you will. You are not who I worry about. The Duke.
Has he asked to beg off, miss?
No. He may wish to.
Every man entertains doubt before the day, I rather think. But it does not signify. He will be a good husband to you. A good father as well. Miss?
He cannot have children. I shall not pretend to understand the extent of his physical impediment, but I imagine it is a source of great pain for the Duke indeed.
I have an aunt. She lives in Greenwich with her husband. They've been married for 10 years now. And never blessed with children, but they still are to each other as husband and wife. Theirs is a happy union.
Because they love each other. At least your aunt has that. I shall not keep you, Rose. You must have 100 things to do.
Of course, miss. Good night.
Ah! Oh, apologies, Your Grace.
Well, our activities are quite spirited.
I admit, I did not even know it was possible. I believed his physical inability to have children would preclude him from
causing such difficult entanglements.
Yes. I'm quite glad to say I was wrong.
If you wanted a Chinese, you should have said. I said, but that is what I said. You just weren't listening to me. And that is what's so annoying about him. He never listens. And then he stormed out. I mean, by that time, I'd made myself a sandwich, because I was eyeing to know he'd gone and got a Chinese.
Oh, no.
So I said to him, well, I'll have it for breakfast. He said, well, you can't have Chinese for breakfast. I said, since when? He made you go to breakfast.
You didn't split up over a takeaway, though.
No, it was everything. We argue all the time, and I said to him, Danny, you do realise we row about literally everything? Then we had a row about that, because we never.
Yeah, the thing is, Zoe, sometimes when people are in a
Oh, it's Becky. Oh, she dyed her hair. No, she got an interview on Monday. But anyway, I just can't go back there. I need my own space. Be right if I stayed.
Of course you can.
Of course.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, don't get me wrong. He's a nice lad. I'm just saying, he gets in a lot of trouble.
Mum, why are you even talking about him?
I'm just saying, beware.
Beware of what? Well, I've just split up with Danny. I'm not looking to go out with anyone else.
Who's that?
Bronson.
I'm referring to anyone who uses this crisis for their own selfish ends. Archie is Archie. Shoots from the hip, straight at his own foot most of the time.
You can't sack him, can you?
Well, I've got bigger things to think of than cabinet reshuffles today, thank you.
Like your daughter's police interview?
All right, they'll do. Thank you very much, everybody.
I think there's enough lynch mobs running around right now. Perhaps we should let due process take its course.
Real classy, Jane. Well done.
80% is in the white zone.
Package that you sent to my mum's work? How could you?
Package?
You sent a package to my mum's work and you know full well what was in it.
No, I don't.
So what do you know?
Look, my stepmum's forever on the internet causing trouble. Is your mum local?
She might be.
Well, Councillor Metcalf rings a bell.
So where is she?
She's not well, she's at the clinic. Look, I will take care of it.
How?
I will talk to her.
I brought you up as my own.
I've got so much to be grateful for.
If you want to go your own way, I can't stop you. Let's not part like this.
This is your doing, not mine. I just hope you don't live to regret it.
Well, why would I do that?
That stuck-up cow might be here now. But she won't before. She'll let you down.